Good morning everyone. My topic of study is thermistry in ocular and adnexal lesion using thermocouple and infrared thermometer. Introducing human metabolic processes and muscular activity generate energy in the form of heat and keeps the core temperature at a slightly oscillating levels. Each body has its own temperature range based on location, environment, vascularity and metabolic activities. With change in hemodynamics, change in temperature can be observed. There are different methods to measure temperature. Some are invasive, being contact means use of needle probes, thermometer and thermocouple, and non-invasive, non-contact means using the infrared wavelength detectors, infrared thermometers and cameras. The application of thermistry is very broad spectral. Apart from medicine, it has been used in medicine to localize enemies by constructor workers, firefighters, and in archaeological surveys recently in the Great Pyramids of Egypt and etc. In medical sciences, it has been used for breast cancer detection, rheumatology, peripheral vascular disease differential, diabetic neuropathies, and in epidemic fever screenings. In ocular sciences, it has been used for the diagnosis of dry eye disease, nasolacrimal duct blockade, bulb functionality after glaucoma surgery, and uveitis. It has been shown to demonstrate low ocular temperatures in vascular occlusions and high temperature in ocular inflammation using most of the infrared cameras. But due to the high cost of infrared cameras, it can't be used in the settings of developing country. So as an alternative and cost-effective means, we have used two simple devices, that is infrared thermometer and thermocouple, to aid in diagnosis of unilateral ocular and adnexal lesions. Aim and objective of the study is to see how effectively temperature difference measured by infrared thermometer and thermocouple to aid in diagnosis of these lesions and to see the agreement between both the devices. Study was prospective, controlled and not blinded. Minimum of 100 patients with uniocular adnexal lesion including the eyelid and lacrimal swellings and the ocular surface lesion, that is the conjunctival and scleral lesions, were used. Material use was thermocouple, which was based on thermoelectric effect, and infrared thermometer, which was based on Planck's black body radiation law. We took the temperature of lesion and the corresponding normal site of the same patient using both the devices in cases of adnexal lesion and only infrared thermometer, that is non-contact thermometer, in cases of conjunctival and scleral lesion. All further ocular examinations were done after recording the temperatures. In this study, we included 128 patients of eyelid lesions, lacrimal swellings, conjunctival lesions and scleral lesion. Among these, there were some diffuse swellings including the preceptor cellulitis, orbital cellulitis, capillary hemangiomas, periorbital ecchymosis. Among the localized, mostly were styes and chalazion. Lacrimal, acute and chronic dacrocystitic. In conjunctival lesions, pterygium, conjunctivitis, ocular surface, squamous neoplasia and inclusion cyst. It was observed that by using both the instrument, that is the infrared thermometer, which is a non-contact, and the contact thermometer, that is the thermocouple, the difference in the temperature was found to be statistically significant in cases of diffuse eyelid swelling, but in case of localized swellings, which were small in size, only the contact means, that is thermocouple, gave the significant difference. In other swellings like lacrimal, conjunctival and scleral swelling, both the temperature difference was found to be statistically significant, and in cases of ocular surface temperature lesions like conjunctival and scleral lesion, it was found to be statistically significant. I would like to mention some special cases which help us to differentiate on the basis of temperature analysis, that were orbital cellulitis. Patient presented with septicemia, but the local temperature, the swelling was found to be cooler. Help us to immediately decide for incision and drainage. Apart from this, the medial rectus myocystic osteoporosis patient which presented at orbital cellulitis, with a temperature analysis, the swelling was found to be cooler and help us to decide. We differentiated pterygium on the basis of cause in respect to their temperature elevation. The progressive pterygium showed the significant elevation in temperature, while other none. To conclude with, the touch method, that is thermocouple, was found to be more specific, but it can't be used on ocular surface, And so I like to conclude that it's an underutilized tool and can be used for diagnosis and prognosis of various lesions. Thank you.